Good morning, everyone. You know, this past weekend, Teresa and I hopped a quick flight to Colorado to visit our oldest son. Well, actually, we went to visit our three of our grandchildren that were there, but we got to see our son and his wife while we were there, but it was really about the grandkids. While there on Sunday afternoon, I received this text from one of the young ladies in our church, and here's the picture she sent me, and then the text was, listening to worship music on my way to work to do a few things. How beautiful. And it was just such a great reminder to me of how all creation declares worship to God. It just hit me in that moment, right at that moment like that. It was just amazing. Later on Sunday evening, our son took us to the area of Aurora, Colorado, where he patrols as a police officer. He patrols the, as he calls it, the fun shift, the night shift graveyard, which is from 10 p.m. to 8 a.m. It's considered the area he patrols is considered the slum or the ghetto of Aurora. And as we drove through the streets late at night, watching all sorts of illegal activity going on, my heart was saddened at how lost everyone seemed to be as they wandered through the streets. On our way back to the house, we were driving through the country roads because he lives out in a little country town. We were climbing up a hill, and there was trees on the horizon of the hill, and as we looked up, there was the most beautiful amber moon we had ever seen. It was just amazing. And you know how sometimes it's just like that moon just rises and it's like right there? It was one of those moments. It was huge. Again, my heart was quickened to remind me that it seemed as though the universe was declaring the worship of God. I was just overwhelmed in that moment again. Psalms 91:1 says, "The heavens declare the glory of God. The skies proclaim the works of his hands." Have you ever been so caught up in what you're doing that you forget to worship God in the everyday moments? So many times in our lives, we fail to remember that we're called to worship God. I dare say, and I hate to say it, but sometimes we even get caught up in worshiping worship rather than worshiping the one worship was created for. See, worship can get twisted around to where we think that worship was designed for us. We think sometimes in our minds, we get twisted around and think that worship was created to move us or was created to be to us, not from us, to give us an emotional experience or to feel good. When we get to that point in our lives, we start hearing phrases come out of our mouths that sound something like this. I didn't like that song, or I don't like it when so-and-so leads or sings. I wasn't moved by worship today. I saw a post on social media from another pastor. He's an author and a pastor, Francis Chan. Some of you may have heard him. And the post said this. It said, "Random churchgoer said, I didn't really like worship today." And Francis Chan responded, "That's okay. We weren't worshiping you." Some of you may think that the Holy Spirit didn't move in a service, but I'm here to tell you that the Holy Spirit is always moving. I'm going to say it again. He's always moving. The question is have you positioned yourself to hear him? Or are your ear filters that you have becoming deaf to his moving? Psalms 148 says, "Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord from the heavens. Praise him in the heights. Praise him, all his angels. Praise him, all his hosts. Praise him, sun. Praise him, moon. Praise him, all you shining stars. Praise him, you highest heavens and you waters above the heavens. Let them praise the name of the Lord, for he commanded and they were created." Psalms 150 verse 6 says, "Let everything that has breath praise the Lord." When we look over in Psalms 19:14, we see that it says, "Let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable and pleasing in your sight, O Lord, my rock and my redeemer." You know, when you think about that, I preached a little bit about this kind of thing on Sunday. The words of my mouth. Let the words of my mouth. What words are coming out of your mouth? What things are you speaking into existence? Are they positive things or are they negative things? Because whatever we think on comes out of our mouth. It says, let the words of my mouth, the meditation of my heart, be acceptable and pleasing in your sight. What are you meditating on? What are you dwelling on? What is in your heart that's coming out of you? Because whatever is in your heart comes out of our mouths. That's the way we're designed. That's the way we were created. Whatever you dwell on, whatever you think on, whatever you push forward in your thought processes is what comes out of how you are. Let the words of my mouth, the meditation of my heart, be acceptable and pleasing in your sight, O Lord, my rock and my redeemer. Today, I just felt impressed. I'm sitting at the piano to just end with a little time of worship together with you. And so I'm going to encourage you just to worship with me wherever you're at. Take a moment, sit down, just focus in on God. And let's just take some time and give him praise. Not worship the songs, whether you know them or don't know them. Worship the one who gave the writers of these songs the music to write it with. Worship God himself, the creator of all. And when you think about worship, it isn't always a song that you sing. Sometimes it's just a moment of adoration of him. I know there's some songs that have come out in the last year that when the worship began on them and I sat there and I just listened to the music because I didn't know it, and I listened to the words of it, I began to just bawl. Why? Because the Spirit of God was touching and moving on me. And he was beginning to chisel away at hard places. And he was beginning to work on me in the areas that he needed to work on. And I just sat in silence with tears streaming down my face, realizing that God was doing something in me. Let's take a moment today, this morning, this afternoon, whenever you're watching this, and let's let God work on us as we worship him together. Worship with me. This is the air I breathe. This is the air I breathe. Your holy presence. This is my daily bread. Your very word spoken to me. Come on, say it with me. And I'm desperate for spoken to me. without you. I'm lost without you. I'm lost, say, oh, I'm lost without you. I'm lost, say, I'm lost without you. God. Leave behind your regrets and mistakes. Come today, there's no reason to wait. Jesus is calling. Do you hear him calling this morning? Do you hear him calling your name? He's crying out for you to spend time with him today. The question is, are you desperate to be with him? Are you desperate to be in his presence? He's worthy of praise. Will you give him that today? In everything you do, praise isn't just words. Acknowledge the creation of God. Acknowledge what he's doing in your life. Acknowledge how much you need him and how desperate you are to be with him. Let me just close this time in prayer today with you. So, Lord, as we've spent moments worshiping you, it wasn't about us. Today, Lord, I sing from this piano to honor you, to worship you. And so today, God, as I'm sitting here and worshiping you, I pray that others have come along with me and began to worship you, realizing, God, that this is what it's all about. So today, Lord, as we've stepped into your presence, let it change the trajectory of our day today. Let the meditation of my heart, the words that I speak, be acceptable and pleasing in your sight, Lord. Today, God, let that be so in each of our lives as we honor and we worship you in everything we do. In your name, God. Amen. Well, today I'm glad you joined me, and I pray that you are glad you joined us also as well. Look forward to seeing you on Sunday as we continue our series, Master Your Mind. If you change your thinking, can change your life. We'll see you Sunday.